Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is Mohammad Mazhar and today's lecture is on brick kiln industry, which is an example of small scale industry. Agenda of the presentation is to introduce the brick kiln industry of Pakistan, to state both natural and human inputs, to describe the brick making or manufacturing processes, to name the areas where bricks are used, to explain the environmental and workers' problems of brick kiln industry, to suggest solutions to improve the brick kiln industry of Pakistan. So here is a brief introduction of brick kiln industry. The use of bricks goes back for more than 3000 years. A brick is still the most preferred household material in most of the countries of the world, including Pakistan. So the brick kiln industry is an important small scale industry of Pakistan. It provides employment to 1 million people, including 1 million people in rural areas and people residing at outskirts of town where agriculture is not enough to sustain all the people in all 4 provinces of Pakistan. Bricks making is traditionally an important and informal sector. According to an estimate, there are 10,000 brick kilns industries in Pakistan, which are producing 45 billion bricks per year. Inputs includes raw material, labor, power and capital. So here is the raw material, which is natural and locally available, includes clay and water. And labor mainly are the family members, including children, can be seen in the photograph. Coal, bagasse, biomass and any low cost fuel, like including tires, battery cases, waste oil or animal dung, is also used as a fuel or power. Capital usually comes from the local investors. There is no investment from foreign. There is no foreign investment, you can see, in this sector. How to make bricks or the processes includes, you can see in the background of this man, there is a depression because the clay is obtained, which is mixed with water, then molded into bricks. Then these bricks are left on ground to get dry under sunlight. These dried bricks are then transported into kiln using donkey carts. Here is a path, here is a route to kiln. And here then these bricks are arranged in columns. One thing you need to notice that there are gaps in between these columns of the bricks. Then it is covered with waste stony soil. But while covering, these gaps are left. And then fire master fill or add coal in these gaps to bake or to burn the bricks. Here you can see the fire in these gaps after adding the coal. And when these bricks are baked, so these bricks are then taken out using hand trolleys or donkey cart. From outside of the kiln, then it is transported using trolleys or sometimes trucks to sale point. Is a recap that clay is obtained, mixed with water, clay is molded into bricks, bricks are left on ground under sunlight to get dry, then transported to kiln, and bricks are arranged properly in columns, covered with stony soil, coal is added into to bake the bricks, and then when bricks are baked, transported out to the kiln using manual trolleys mostly. Here's the route. I would like to add here for your information. Here's the route here that you can see the one route is going towards left, another going towards right. Here you can see, here the bricks are added and from here the bricks are taken out. On daily basis, 15,000 to 20,000, 15,000 to 18,000 bricks are baked. Therefore, these bricks are taken out from the kilns and the same number of bricks then are required to be placed for baking. So this is the continuous process on daily basis. 15,000 to 18,000 bricks are placed in the kiln, which is taken in the kiln, and the baked bricks are taken out from the kiln. So here is a short video on brick making processes. For your further understanding, watch this short video.
Materials. They have been used since about 3000 BC in early Indus Valley cities. Sun-dried mud bricks are much older and quite satisfactory in hot, dry climates. Fired bricks are much more resistant to cold and moist weather conditions. Welcome to Terra Support. Subscribe now. From the mold, ground preparation has been completed. Plain sandy surface. Brick is left on the ground. After molding process, the bricks contain some amount of raw bricks as done by the natural process. Ducts should be arranged in such a way that circulation of air between the bricks is free. It also depends on the weather conditions. The drying yards are also filled during burning. So that they can be handled and stacked in greater heights in the kiln for burning without damage. Kilns, large scale, up to certain degree temperature. In this stage, the bricks will gain hardness and strength, so it is an important stage in the manner. If they burned up, Poland woods are being used for high temperature 1100 centigrade. Intermittent and continuous kilns. Molded take as much as 2 weeks. These processes are carried out intermittently in intermittent kilns and in cyclic order in continuous kilns.
will be familiar with the uses of bricks, which includes the lining of canal, construction of houses and industry, and to cover the underground cables. Environmental problems includes the air pollution, land degradation, and loss of agricultural land. Air pollution, because the thick brick industries emit thick dark smoke from the chimneys, which contains different kind of air pollutants, includes carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, and nitrogen dioxide. So these are the pollutants emitted from the chimneys because the low quality or the poor quality cheap fuel is used by these brickkiln industries. The type of coal which is used in brickkiln industry is lignite, which is considered the poor quality coal because it produces more smoke, less heat. Another problem is the land degradation. So land get degrade when clay is obtained and depressions are formed. So it means the land get deformed, or you can call it the land, the natural landscape get changed, so it get degrade. And the third is the loss of agricultural land. This is because when depressions are formed during monsoon season, when heavy rainfall, these gaps are filled with water and cause water logging and salinity, and different kind of diseases like malaria, etc. is produced because of these depressions. Another way of that agricultural land is getting waste because of the brick kilns. In most of the areas where the agriculture is not enough to sustain the growing population, I mean the income of the rural people is not increasing, so comparatively it's a business which gives more income. So this land is being used for brickkiln industry. So in this way the agricultural land is getting waste. The third way of agricultural land to get waste is from these chimneys. Dust or smoke is also, some smoke or dust come out and it spread in the vicinity and affect the soil of the local area. Next, the workers' problems, which includes the child labor, which is very much common, and there is no schooling opportunities for children. And now with the efforts of the government, now the owners offer their workers to send their children to school if they can afford, if they don't need to have supportive role of the children. So but due to illiteracy, these people, the workers, even they are not ready. Most of the cases they are not ready to send them to school. And unsafe drinking water is another problem. They don't have supply of most of these workers don't have supply of unsafe drinking water. Poor housing is another factor. This is one of the reason is because these workers, they don't stay at one place. They don't intend to stay for long time at one place where they find a good package, or if a industry offer them a good package or wages, so they move to another kiln. So always the owners, they feel difficult to make them stay at their kiln. So for this they use different techniques, like one is the debt bondage. So the owners encourage their workers to get loans, and the loans when they are unable to pay back, in this way they are bound to stay and to work on the same kiln, whether the wages are offered are not enough or they are less, or whether they are being offered a good wage or good contract with another entrepreneur of another kiln. know which rise as per the inflation rate and inadequate medical support, and sometimes they are offered or they are given 200 rupees in case of any injury, or if workers demand more than 200 rupees for medical support, so these money is given to them, but this money is then deducted from their wage. And the common diseases are TB, body pain, HS and baggage, diarrhea, fever, cough, heat stroke, asthma and malaria, in which these poor workers, they do suffer in. Measures to improve the brick kiln industry. Number one, the strict implementation of environmental and child labor laws. Number two, switch to natural gas to control of air pollution. Use of mask to avoid inhalation of dangerous gases. Chimneys should be fixed at a greater height, at a great height, to reduce the degree of pollution. Most of the chimneys, their height is between 65 feet to 120 feet. So their height must be increased as much as it is possible. Another way is the use of modern technology for drying processes, which is now in use in the developed world. So instead of drying bricks under the sunlight, it is better to use the technology because it will increase the process. And providing and improving healthcare, educational and living conditions by the government or by the entrepreneur or owners, etc. UNDP, United Nations Development Programs, has introduced a program in Pakistan, which is SGP, with the name of SGP, Small Grants Program for Pakistan. So in this, this program, they have offered Pakistan to install, they are providing assistance to Pakistani entrepreneurs to improve their brick kiln with new techniques, and in which air pollution is less and the material like power, coal, etc., when they are used, so less heat escape, and there are many other advantages of this program which has recently been introduced in Pakistan. Okay, this was all in this presentation. Thank you very much, and keep watching upcoming videos. For this, you need to like and subscribe this channel. Allah Hafiz.